Just imagine plot twist, it's Rachel Amber.
What is this?
Oh, no, that's definitely too dark.
Let's open it. From Bloody Bill. Who's that? Oh, get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Ahoy there, plank walkers. It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What the heck?
By now, you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed. And always remember, the real treasure is...
friendship.
Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
Ugh.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground.
Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive!
Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. To Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you were so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
Dear Chloe, how are you today? I am doing very well. It is Friday, June 27, 2003. It is summer vacation. We are making a time capsule for you and me in the future. We are making it pirate themed. Wasn't it hilarious to find? These are some things we like. Favorite animal, Arabian horse, Max. Otter, Chloe. Favorite food, lobster roll, Max. Coffee ice cream, Chloe. Favorite class in school, art or library, Max. Science, Chloe. Best friend, each other, both. How about you? Are you age 12 or more? What are your favorite foods, movies, etc.? That's all for now. I hope you're having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Sincerely, Maxine Caulfield. I prefer Max to Maxine. No, Maxine is the alternate version of Maxine at the end of episode 3 and beginning of episode 4. Which I like that little touch, how she prefers Maxine to Max. Like a subtle difference to him, but you know, I still like it. I like little subtle changes like that. Dear Maxine, hello from 2003. Here is a record of how we spend our days. Can you guess which one is real? 1. We go to the same school and always sit together at lunch. Duh. 2. We have sleepovers at least once a week. 3. We like extremely salty pretzels. 4. We are in a race to see who can convince your parents to get a pet first. 5. We are going to live together when we can afford it and use only gold paint. 6. We have battled many foes and never failed to save each other. What did you guess? If you guessed all of them, you are right. Your friend forever, Chloe Elizabeth Price.
You were really funny. Mine was so serious.
Well, yeah, that's you. Serious and genuine.
This is so cool. There's so much to look at. Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now.
Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff.
I'm gonna draw something.
all these memories. I want to look at everything. Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present instead.
Predictions for the future by Chloe and Maxine. 1. We still hang out with each other more than with any other person. 2. Both of us are medium popular. 3. Both of us are dating our second boyfriend. 4. We do not make decisions without consulting each other, the talking skull of our enemies. 5. Both of us have a pet. 6. Chloe has visited Antarctica. Max could have come if she wanted. 7. One of us has a little sister or brother. 8. We are doing well in school.
These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do.
A chopper, world's most comfortable seat. Switches pedals from wheels to blades. Also spins blades. Flaming fingers, flint and steel. That's a good idea. Wait, no, that's a bad idea. I mean, it's a good idea for starting a fire, but you might burn yourself. Because that's how you use your thumb and your middle finger to click your fingers, right? Because I always use, when I'm clicking my fingers, like snapping, I always use my thumb and index. I can't do it with my thumb and middle finger. It's always thumb and index. Because I thought that's how you do it. Ray of sunshine. Sunlight enters. Mirrors and lenses to straighten sunlight. Laser beam shoots out here. Opens intake window.
A time capsule. Holy crap. It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross.
Maybe you should come down and power of flight this dude's face with me.
This container looks like it could last 100 years. Lupin, we used to read every issue from cover to cover.
It's a butterfly. Oh my god, stories for children from around the world.
Lupin, we used to
maybe
read
this
every
is a sign for
to
things
cover.
To come. Or it could be a coincidence.
We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house. Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds me.
Yeah, I'm such a good friend. You won't see the real me doing that at a friend's house. I'll be like, nah, you tidy up your own stuff.
Much
own dishes.
Better.
I'm the guest, so I'm allowed to be the slovenly one.
I always look especially short next to Chloe.
I remember when I first played this, because my original walkthrough, when this episode came out, should still be up on YouTube. When I first played this, and I saw this photo, I was like, oh, are you shitting me? Because this is, this photo was taken, well, this is the photo that Max uses to travel back in time at the end of episode 3. So when I saw this, I was like, oh, are you shitting me? This is the day William died. I was like,
that was a
I
good
felt
one.
Like I took a gut punch.
I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast.
Good luck, hubby. We are so proud of your promotion. You get a week of two whales waffles in your own house. Your loving wifey.
Chloe's grandparents live in Idaho now. I guess, compared to that, Seattle's not so far. I wonder if that's the voicemail Chloe's mom was talking about. She did say she didn't want Chloe to hear it, but if Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell, this might be my only chance to get her to talk about it.
No, I remember this. It wasn't Chloe's fault. It was that little bitch's fault.
This is Anne Rogers, Marissa's mother. Marissa from Blackwell. I need to talk to you about what your daughter did to Marissa in class today. I'll be keeping Marissa home with me tomorrow. At this point, I'm not comfortable sending her back to school at all. I don't know if your daughter is having trouble adjusting or what, but this needs to be addressed.
Hey, hold on. Are you serious? I don't want my parents to hear that. I've never gotten in trouble like this before.
They already know. I saw an email on your parents' computer.
Shit.
What happened?
Something so minor. Her mom is exaggerating. I bet Marissa told her that I'm telling you, it's stupid.
They both sound awful. Marissa and her mom.
They are. All Marissa talks about is, like, how much she hates her tutor, but she never does any homework. I told you, I hate fake people.
Is everybody there like that?
No, not everyone. But more than I'm used to. Anyway, she wouldn't leave me alone, so I turned up her Bunsen burner in science. Just a little.
What?
No one got hurt, not even close. You know that I know what I'm doing.
Chloe, what do you mean she wouldn't leave you alone?
She was making fun of my clothes and calling me a scholarship kid.
Hey, you can handle this. You're so much cooler than she is.
Just to you. Thanks, Max.
It's good to see you, old friend. Recording things was so much fun in third grade.
No peeking at my work.
I wasn't.
Get out of here.
You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope.
Bro. There's one thing I like, love about Life is Strange, it's the music in it. You know, like Life is Strange, Fort Storm, Life is Strange 2, True Colors.
I wish this moment could
last. They always get you with the music. Well, they always get me with the music. I don't know about all of you, but they always get me.
Chloe and I have been friends for so long.
Oh,
maybe
sorry.
I'm worrying too much about this move changing things.
Halloween 2001. Halloween 2002. I don't know what that is.
Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO? Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it. You sure were troublesome to find. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this.
Sailing by the Wind, stories about women changing careers in
That's
midlife.
That's so cool that Chloe's mom is
by,
thinking
who's it
about
by?
This.
Edited by Claire Cassidy.
There. Now you've got something pretty to look at.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
Oh, gosh. I really miss Bongo.
I saw you giving him a flower.
Poor Bongo.
It was so sweet.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She's already got enough drama from Blackwell.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right? Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle. Really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
Why did you pretend like you didn't know?
I don't know. I guess I didn't want it to be true. We were both doing it, weren't we? All that pirate stuff. Doing the treasure hunt. Wasn't that fun?
Of course, but...
Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so... I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
I'm so worried that I won't be okay without you.
Hey, stop that. Of course you'll be okay. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Can't watch this. The feels! Damn it! Nice music's getting to me. I'm gonna have to black flies on the window seat. Take off my headphones. I can't listen to this music. It's gonna get me. Winter stole summer's thrill, and the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land. A darkened plume to stay. Hope it needs a humble hand. Not a fox found in your place. Thank you.
I was just a stone.
This is like, do you think do you think Chloe was buried next to William if you choose to sacrifice her? Because I think it would be sweet if they're buried next to each other, but I don't know. Still I'd be a traveler. Maybe that's a theory video I have to work on. A gypsy's reins to face, but the road is weary with that full found. This is such bullshalaka right here, I'm telling ya. Like, Chloe's dad is not even, his coffin's not even in the ground, and Max's parents are taking Max away to Seattle. They could at least, like, stay a few extra days. I mean, seriously. Like, both Max's parents would suck my Willy Wonka and eat my chocolate factory. I mean, that's how I personally feel about this, because this is not okay. This is like if you have a parent, and you go to the funeral and you're like, oh, I can't stay for the funeral, I'm just here to collect my inheritance, and then I'll be on my way. Like, who does that? Ugh.
If I could just see you, but we'll get good at it, great at it. We'll write and talk all the time, and then you'll come visit, and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen, even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always.
Yeah, but then again, you know, like, goddamn it, Max. She doesn't get in contact with Chloe for like 5 years, like, I mean, she still sends us some messages and that, you can find it before the storm, like, but still, you know, just, like, god damn it, Max. But then again, I guess the situation was uncomfortable for her as well, because that's what we do as humans, like, we tend to avoid uncomfortable situations. And that can be both a good or a bad thing, depending on the circumstance. Goddamn. Alright, so that's the end of this episode. I hope you all enjoyed it. And now we're going to be getting to episode 1 in my next video. I hope you all enjoyed this, and I'll see you in the next one.